22-year-old Amanda Gorman captivated the nation with her words at President Biden's inauguration. Her poem, The Hill We Climb, offered a hopeful vision for this deeply divided country.
The dawn is ours before we knew it. Somehow we do it. Somehow we've weathered and witnessed a nation that isn't broken, but simply unfinished. We, the successors of a country and a time where a skinny black girl descended from slaves and raised by a single mother, can dream of becoming president only to find herself reciting for one.
Anderson Cooper had a chance to interview Amanda Gorman last night.
Amanda Gorman, it is such a pleasure. First of all, how do you feel?
I feel just so overjoyed and so grateful and so humbled. You know, I came here to do the best with the poem that I could, and to just see the support that's been pouring out, I literally can't absorb it all. So I'll be processing it for a while.
Can you just explain why this message today? How did you go about crafting this?
Right. Well, you know, I did a lot of research ever since I found out in late December that I was going to be the inaugural poet. So that was making sure I read all of the previous inaugural poems, really doing a deep literature dive of other orators who I look up to, whether it be Frederick Douglass and Abraham Lincoln, and how they speak to a nation that can feel very divided. And I was around halfway through that process and kind of that research when the January 6th insurrection happened at the Capitol. And I'm not going to say that that completely, you know, derailed the poem, because I was not surprised at what had happened. I had seen the signs and the symptoms for a while, and I was not trying to turn a blind eye to that. But what it did is it energized me even more to believe that much more firmly in a message of hope and unity and healing. I felt like that was the type of poem that I needed to write, and it was the type of poem that the country and the world needed to hear.
Were there particular images from January 6th that, you know, that were kind of foremost in your mind, or was it just the totality of the horror of the insurrection?
I'm a poet, so often I don't work in images. I work in words and text. And so what I was actually doing is, while keeping my mental sanity, looking through the tweets and the messages and the articles and seeing what stood out. And there's a line in the poem that you might have heard, which is, "We've seen a force that would shatter our nation rather than share it." And I got that actually from looking through a few tweets and a lot of people being like, wow, this is what happens when people don't want to share the country with the rest of us. And so I took that, which often became a meme on Twitter, and I put that in the poem.
It's so interesting to me that you're not thinking visual, that you're not, it's not the images that motivate you, it's the text, the words that you come across.
Right. To me, words matter, and I think that's kind of what made this inauguration that much more sentimental and special. We've seen over the past few years the ways in which the power of words has been violated and misappropriated. And what I wanted to do is to kind of reclaim poetry as that site in which we can re-purify, re-sanctify not only the Capitol building, which we saw violated, but the power of words, and to invest that in kind of the highest office of the land. We will rebuild, reconcile, and recover in every known nook of our nation, in every corner called our country. Our people, diverse and beautiful, will emerge battered and beautiful. When day comes, we step out of the shade, aflame and unafraid. The new dawn blooms as we free it. For there is always light, if only we're brave enough to see it, if only we're brave enough to be it.
I got shivers when you said that. I mean, that is what it takes, isn't it? It's bravery. It takes bravery to see it and to be that light.
You know, I'm so grateful you brought up the last line. It's something that I've been seeing a lot of people repeat. And to be honest, I was concerned of whether I should include that last line of be it at all. I was kind of deliberating between see it, be it, free it. And then I said, you know what, we need all of these things at once. We need that cacophony. We need to realize that hope isn't something that we ask of others. It's something that we have to demand from ourselves. And that's what I wanted the poem to end on.
I had a form of dyslexia as a child and a kind of a minor speech issue, a slight little stutter. Joe Biden has talked about this. I read that you had some form of a speech impediment or may still have, which is obviously something you would have in common with President Biden. He's talked often about overcoming it. And I understand that you use writing to cope with it, to share your voice that way. Can you talk about that a little bit?
Yeah. I'm proud to be in the speech difficulty club with you and President Biden and also Maya Angelou. You know, growing up, I had a speech impediment. And for me, it wasn't stutter. It was, you know, dropping a whole swath of letters in the alphabet. So for, I want to say, most of my life, up until 2 or maybe 3 years ago, I couldn't say the letter R. Even to this day, sometimes I struggle with it, which is difficult when you have a poem in which you say rhymes like 5 times.
I understand you have a mantra that you say before every reading you give. Can you reveal what that is?
Certainly. I do it whenever I perform, and I definitely did it this time. And I close my eyes and I say, I'm the daughter of Black writers. We are descended from freedom fighters who broke their chains and changed the world. They call me.
Hillary Clinton tweeted a picture of you two from the inauguration today saying, wasn't at the Amanda Gorman's poem just stunning? She's promised to run for president in 2036, and I, for one, can't wait. President Gorman has a nice ring to it, doesn't it?
Yes, it does. Madam President Gorman, I like the sound of that.
I've seen that. I've seen hashtag Amanda Gorman 2036 repeated.
I will tell you, I've never seen anything like that in my entire life. To see someone that full of so much knowledge and so much depth. Forget the age, honestly. Forget the age. The idea that she talked about of wanting to reclaim words. The fact that one of the things we've learned so much is that words matter, and that Amanda Gorman single-handedly walked in front of the world and took words back. I mean, wow. I mean, honestly, it is stunning. And also just to hear an artist talk in that detail, that frankly, in a way that I can understand, because I don't understand much poetry. And to hear someone like that explain it to me so frankly and matter-of-factly was also, you know, what a thing.
No, I totally agree. Her way with words, of course, is what is part of what is so special. And her wisdom. I mean, her wisdom, it was just felt like exactly what we needed to hear yesterday. And I'm sure we have not heard the last of Amanda Gorman.
I got to say, Robert Frost, Maya Angelou, Amanda Gorman, those are some of the people who've recited their poetry at inaugurations before. What a group.